Greetings, I'm Mr. Spiffy. Happy holidays and welcome to the Royal Road. Well, this year's Royal Rumble was the 2011, and the 2011 Royal Rumble was the first Royal Rumble to feature a 40-man Rumble. So I figured, all right, first 40-man Rumble, first time I do a fireside review. So, we had the fire going, and I just decided to do it, so it had nothing to do with it whatsoever. No, but it's actually kind of cool in that way. Wood chunks. Anyway, let's take a look at the 2011 Royal Rumble, which had a rather thin undercard because they had to fit so much into one matchup. So we start off right away with the World Heavyweight Championship, Edge versus Dolph Ziggler. Probably one of the best matches of the night besides maybe the Royal Rumble match itself. Both men doing their best to really go out there and put on one hell of a matchup. Dolph Ziggler getting a chance at a world title for the first multiple times, because the one I'm watching currently, he also has a WWE Championship matchup as well. Both men worked really well together. In the end, I believe this was the one that Vicky Guerrero takes the 619 to the back of the head. Oh, no, sorry, that was Rey Mysterio. Never mind. That was a couple years ago, sorry. This one, Vicky's out there. The spear is banned, that's what it was. And Edge still manages to steal the spear towards the end of it, and then finishes off Dolph Ziggler with the Unprettier, or Kill Switch, whatever you want to call it, in honor of his friend Christian. And, you know, it's kind of sad to think that we didn't know it at the time, but this was the countdown to the end of Edge's career as an in-ring performer. But we got one heck of a match out of them. And this was also during Michael Cole's heel run, where Michael Cole was, you know, well, being a total douchebag on TV, and so it was really hard to watch and listen to. We then move on to the WWE Championship match. I gave that match a B+, sorry. We move on to the WWE Championship match, Randy Orton versus The Miz. Miz's only WWE title reign, not the most spectacular. In this matchup, we have close calls, decent, okay, back and forth. In the end, Punk and the New Nexus help Miz win, and Michael Cole pretty much jizzes his pants over the fact that Miz is still the WWE champion. You know, you can practically hear the orgasm coming out of Michael Cole. It was frighteningly awful. As far as the match went, it was all right, slightly above average. I gave the match a C+. It was the last time we had Randy Orton versus Miz one-on-one for this WWE championship during this title run. I got to go to the event that happened the following month at Elimination Chamber, where I saw The Miz defend the title against Jerry the King Lawler, which actually also stands as the only Jerry the King Lawler match I ever saw live in person, but I'm glad I got to see him wrestle before he retired. You have Todd Grisham reading a statement from Dashing Cody Rhodes about how Rey Mysterio callously shattered his face. What started off, we then move on to what started off was supposed to be a 2-on-1 Divas Championship matchup, Lay Cool versus Natalya, but then the Raw GM, the anonymous Raw GM, all these times I wish I could forget, turns it into a fatal four-way matchup where it's now Layla, Michelle McCool, Natalya, and Eve Torres. Eve Torres picks up the win in the matchup. The only really good part of this was the double sharpshooter on Eve and Layla. Otherwise, this match was kind of crappy. I gave it a C-. It really wasn't all that spectacular. Eve becomes a new Divas champion. You get Daniel Bryan backstage with Gail Kim when the Bellas come to apologize to Kim and Bryan. After some insults, it breaks down into a fight. And who knew this angle would have actually brought together two people like Daniel Bryan and Brie Bella? That was pretty much the beginning of their relationship. It was them doing the whole angle where the Bellas were trying to see who could get Daniel Bryan laid first. And apparently Brie won that one. We move on to the Royal Rumble match itself. Now, I didn't remember much about this Rumble outside of it being a 40-man and the fact that Alberto Del Rio won and we had that close call with Santino. The close call that, even watching this matchup again, I wanted to see history change because, by God, Del Rio is so boring. And I hate to say this, but Santino versus Edge as Edge's last match would have been more entertaining. Hell, even if they did what they did with Rey Mysterio, where Randy Orton winds up interjecting himself. So in this case, you have Santino win, but Del Rio finds a way to interject himself into the title opportunity, and it becomes a triple threat match. Even that would have been a more entertaining matchup than what we got out of Edge versus Del Rio. And it wasn't Edge's fault. Del Rio just was boring as shit at the time. I mean, I've taken shits that were more entertaining. Now that I've gotten that out of the way, let's talk about the rest of the Royal Rumble match itself. So, we start off the event where CM Punk draws number one, and then the Core comes out and goes to attack him, but the New Nexus get in. We had a huge brawl. The anonymous Raw GM says that if they don't leave, then none of them are going to get to participate in the 40-man Rumble, because they really have eight other men that they can fill that spots with. Yeah, fucking right. So, we then get Daniel Bryan coming out as number two, which... it was nice to actually see both Punk and Bryan as one and two. That was actually a really solid way to start off the event. So let's take a look at the stats that came out of this Rumble match and this particular one. So CM Punk has the longest time in the Rumble at 35 minutes and 21 seconds, which is not very spectacular when you consider that with a 40-man Rumble, they could have broken a number of records, but they didn't choose to. Punk garnered 7 eliminations, that's including the ones he did with the help of Nexus, him and the rest of Nexus all together. Just on his own, he did 4. That tie, you want to consider that the most eliminations, sure, but then that would also, John Cena did 5 on his own. So if you count the on the own, Punk wasn't the most eliminations, it was John Cena. If you count it with him help with the Nexus, then yes. You have Tyler Rex, who picked up the shortest time in the ring at 34 seconds. You have Tyson Kidd get AA'd by Hornswoggle. Hornswoggle actually lasted in there a surprisingly long time. I mean, Hornswoggle was in there for just under 10 minutes, which, for a 4'5" man, that's reasonably impressive. I mean, yeah, he had Cena covering him most of that time, but it was still pretty impressive for him to last that long. Del Rio picks up the win at the impressive number 38 position. 38! That's the same as winning from number 28. And then he's like, I beat 40 men! I am the man of destiny! No, you're not! Fuck you! You didn't win anything! If you had come in at, say, number 10 and lasted through 30 fucking men... yeah, you deserve it. And you have Santino, who, okay, admittedly he came in at number 37. But Santino had his longest run in the Rumble, technically lying on the floor after the bro kick. He was in the Rumble for just a little under 10 minutes himself. So Santino has beaten his worst records, because before his records were something like 1 second and like 35 seconds. So Santino does not exactly have the best record in the Royal Rumble match itself. Which is funny considering the fact that I played a number of Royal Rumble simulations on the WWE games. And Santino won surprisingly number of times. So did Eugene. That was really weird.
Yeah, he always lasted a really long time in the computer one.
So... no real records broken, nothing really special. Alright, so you have... the big special thing was... everybody beyond number 30 is special! Which means nobody is. Because, let's be honest, you know... they set it up this way, this was the 40-man Rumble. Yay, you did something different. That being said, and I know I sound like I'm giving this Rumble a lot of shit... there was a lot of entertainment to be had out of this Rumble. John Morrison's, leap and land, actually catching himself on the barricade and being able to make it back over, was the first time we got to see one of those special times where really someone avoided elimination. We had a lot of entertaining moments with Hornswoggle, with Santino coming oh so very close to winning the opportunity to go to WrestleMania. And I know I sound like an idiot saying that I wanted Santino to do it, but you know what? I want WWE to really throw a curveball at me. I want a Royal Rumble where it's not totally obvious who should win. I mean, hell, the years where it was obvious where someone should win and they threw a curveball at us, it was still stupid. Like, it was blatantly obvious that Mr. Perfect should have won in 1990, but instead, Hulk Hogan won. That being said, the Rumble match itself was still enjoyable. I gave it a B+. Despite the fact that some of this event really did drag and carry out badly, especially Orton versus The Miz, that was a long matchup, I gave the overall a B. I think this 2011 Royal Rumble still matched up. Had the 40-man Rumble been truly boring, that would have just killed this. They've never done a 40-man again. I can't say they necessarily is a good idea for them to ever try to do a 40-man again. I've had some people ask me if they think they should do a 50-man Rumble, and I'm like, are you kidding me? The next thing you know, if you're going to go overboard with it, let's really go overboard with it. Let's have a Royal Rumble where the entire event, 3 hours long, is the Royal Rumble. And have someone have to last in the Rumble for like 2 fucking hours. Let's see them do that shit. Because that would be entertaining. And again, it could be really boring if you're watching the same match for 3 fucking hours. I don't know. What do you think? Am I insane? Well, I guess that's a given. Anyway, as always, feel free to tell me your comments on the 2011 Royal Rumble. Was it one that you liked? Was it one that you hated? Do you think that Santino should have won? Maybe you like Alberto Del Rio more than I do. I haven't seen too many matches with him that I've really found entertaining. Feel free to like, share, subscribe, and comment. Next time on the Royal Road, we're taking a look at the one that I'm watching over here on the TV, the 2012 Royal Rumble, which so far isn't stacking up all that well. All right, see you guys soon.